Kurunji Senior Secondary School, CBSE, Namakkal.
Successful, result-producing school in state every year.
Administered by the Board of Directors with over 35 years of experience in the teaching field.
Special attention on art, craft, music, dance, silambam, yoga, skating and karate.
Focus on Hindi Sabha and Spell Bee Olympiad exams.
Smart class for effective and innovative learning and well-furnished library.
Solitary importance on sports and games in state and national level.
WhatsApp facilities to know activities of students and school inside the campus.
Free bus for LKG to 8th standard.
Free hygienic and nutritious food.
NEET, JEE, IIT coaching experts from Rajasthan and Andhra Pradesh along with our effective teachers.
Admission registration for classes LKG to plus 2.
Kurunji Education Institution, Kavetipatti, Namakkal. Admission in progress. CBSE, KG to 12th, contact 9025895176. Metric 6 to 12th, contact 9344567484. For online admission, log on to www.kurunjischoolnkl.in.
Good morning, students. Today onwards, we are going to discuss another important chapter from organic chemistry, amines. Actually, in CBSE 12th standard test book, this chapter name is organic compounds containing nitrogen atoms. It's a very, very important chapter. From this chapter, there are four different type of topics are there. Number one, first part is amines. Number two, diazo salts. Number three, isocyanates and cyanates. Number four, nitro compounds. Especially in the CBSE point of view, amines and diazonium salts are important. Remaining part is not important, but in the NEET point of view, all parts are important. Nitro compounds and amines and diazonium salts also. Okay, today onwards, we are going to discuss amine chapter. Today, we are going to discuss another new chapter from the organic chemistry. The chapter name is organic compounds containing nitrogen. Organic compounds containing nitrogen. Actually, in this chapter, there are four different type of parts are there. Part one, amines, and part two, isocyanates and cyanides, and part three, diazonium salts, and part four, nitro compounds. In CBSE 12th standard, amines and diazonium salts, these two parts are very, very important. Now, we will start part one, amines. See here, the introduction part of the organic compounds containing nitrogen chapter. Now the amines. Amines may be regarded as derivatives of ammonia. This is the most important point. Again, write down. Amines may be regarded as a derivatives of ammonia formed by the replacement of one or more hydrogen atom by corresponding number of the alkyl and or aryl groups. So these are the amines. It means, my dear students, actually amines are generally the derivatives of ammonia group. All kind of amines, 1 degree amines or 2 degree amines or 3 degree amines, all amines are generally derivatives of ammonia. It means from the ammonia group, one hydrogen is replaced. One hydrogen is removed by replacement of either alkyl group or aryl group. That is called generally amines. Now see here in this place, this is amine group NH3. From the amine group, one hydrogen is replaced. One hydrogen is removed, not replaced. One hydrogen is removed and attaches by or addition by the alkyl group or aryl group. This combination or NH2, instead of one hydrogen from the amine group, one alkyl group or aryl group are attached. This is called 1 degree amines or primary amine. My dear students, listen very carefully. Whenever you will see or NH2 group, that is generally 1 degree amines. Next, 2 degree amines means from the ammonia, two hydrogens are removed by replacement of two alkyl group or two aryl group, hence R2NH group is formed. This R2NH group is nothing but generally 2 degree or secondary amines, 2 degree amines or secondary amines. Now here 3 degree amines. This 3 degree amine means from the ammonia group, three hydrogens are removed by replacement of the three alkyl group or aryl group, that is commonly known as a
3-degree amines or tertiary amines. So 1-degree amine, 2-degree amine and 3-degree amine. My dear students, now we are going to discussing only amines point of view. So here amines, generally 1-degree amines, 2-degree amines or 3-degree amines, how they are formed. Actually all different kind of the amines from derivatives of ammonia. From the ammonia group, one hydrogen is replaced and addition by one alkyl group or aryl group, that is called 1-degree, and two hydrogens are removed, additions by or replacement by the two alkyl group or aryl group, that is a 2-degree, and three hydrogens removed from the ammonia group and replacement by three alkyl group or three aryl group, that is called 3-degree amines. Now especially in the 1-degree amines point of view, this is ammonia group, one hydrogen replace, additions of one or alkyl group or aryl group, 1-degree amines are formed. Once again I repeated, my dear students, here R is nothing but either alkyl group or aryl group, amines are classified as primary amines and secondary amine and tertiary amines depending on the number of alkyl group or aryl group attaches to the nitrogen atom, a primary amine has only one alkyl group or aryl group directly attaches to nitrogen atom, in case of the primary amine, see here, this is a primary amine. In case of the primary amine, either one alkyl group or one aryl group directly attaches to the nitrogen atom from the amine group. That this is the nitrogen atom, either only one alkyl group or aryl group is attached, this is called 1-degree amine, 1-degree amine. That so now example here, see nana, 1-degree amines example, CH3NH2, methyl amine, ethyl amine and propyl amine, etc. These are the 1-degree amine. Once again, my dear students, 1-degree amine or primary amine means only one alkyl group or aryl group directly attaches to the nitrogen atom of the ammonia derivatives, and this is the 1-degree amines. Now 2-degree amines, here see, here 2-degree amines, NH3 remove of two hydrogen atom by replace of here 2R. Here 2R, now R2NH group is formed. Here 2R nana. NH3, 2H or 2R, R2NH group is there. This is the secondary amines. My dear students, a secondary amines, listen very carefully, a secondary amine has two alkyl or two aryl groups directly attaches to the nitrogen atom or NH2 group, which is known as amino group means two alkyl group or two aryl group directly attaches to the nitrogen atom from the ammonia derivatives like NH, that is called amino group, I-M-I-N-O, amino group, which is known as amino group. And my dear students, this 2-degree amines or secondary amines further classified into two categories. Number one, simple amines. Number two, mixed amines. Especially in 2-degree amines category, two different type of classifications are present here. Number one, simple amines. Number two, mixed amines. My dear students, see here right side. Simple amine means if 2-degree amines contain only one kind of alkyl group, or aryl group, that is called simple amine. Now here see, dimethyl amine. Dimethyl amine means the alkyl group or aryl group are same. So simple amines are nothing but if 2-degree amines contains same category of the alkyl group or same category of the aryl group, that is considered as a simple amine. Now see here, CH3NH, R group are same, and see one more example, C2H5NH, this is also same, alkyl group or aryl group here same, this is also simple amines. Okay ma? Now mixed amines, mixed amine means in the 2 degree amines or secondary amine, if alkyl group or aryl group are different, if alkyl group or aryl group are different, it's called mixed amines. Now here see, this is a methyl group and ethyl group. So methyl group, ethyl methyl amine, this name is ethyl methyl amine. Why is called first ethyl? Here two alkyl groups are there, methyl group or ethyl group. Why the first priority goes to ethyl group? According to IUPAC rules and regulation, if two different type of alkyl groups are present in the given organic compound, you should be follow the alphabetical order. Now ethyl is the first letter E, methyl is the next letter. So that's why this compound name is, my dear students, ethyl methyl amine. Now here ethyl propyl amine, this is ethyl propyl amine. So this is phenyl group, aromatic ring, and methyl groups also there. Okay ma, what is a mixed amines? If any one of the 2 degree or secondary amines contains two different type of alkyl group or two different type of the aryl group, that is called mixed amines. My dear students, the simple amines or mixed amines generally you are observed in the 2 degree category of the amines is nothing but amino group. You know, amino group is nothing but 2 degree amines or secondary amines. Okay, clear ma? These are the secondary amines. What is the secondary amines, my dear student? See here, if two hydrogens are removed from the ammonia derivative after additional or replacement of two alkyl group or two aryl group, that is called 2 degree amines or amino groups. So in the 2 degree amines, two different type of amines are there. Number one, simple amine. Number two, mixed amine. Simple amines means same category of the alkyl group or same category of the aryl group. And mixed amines means different type of alkyl group or different type of aryl groups. This is the secondary amines. Now my dear students, here 3 degree amines.
I can't help you with that at the moment.
3 degree amines. Now see here, 3 degree. 3 alkyl or 3 aryl groups directly attaches to the nitrogen atom, it means N. You know, 3 different alkyl groups are 3 same alkyl group, 3 different aryl groups are 3 same alkyl groups directly attaches to nitrogen atom from the ammonia derivative group, that is called 3 degree amines. That is called 3 degree amines. These are also simple and mixed categories all there, simple and mixed. Now see here, this is a nitrogen atom. From actually this is a ammonia derivative, NH3 derivative, but here instead of 3 hydrogen atom replaced by the 3 methyl group, that's why N directly attaches to 3 different type of alkyl group, that's why it's considered as a 3 degree amines. 3 degree amine, it means the nitrogen group contains 3 methyl groups or 3 alkyl groups or 3 aryl groups, that's why it's considered as a 3 degree amine. And moreover, this example trimethyl amine, this name is trimethyl amine, it's a simple amine. Why it's called simple amine? Same category of the alkyl groups are directly attached to the nitrogen atom, that's why it's a 3 degree amines of simple amine. Now here see mixed amines. Here first two alkyl groups are similar and third alkyl groups are different. This is a methyl, two alkyl groups are methyl, this is the ethyl, also it's considered as a mixed, the mixed amines, but 3 degree amines. Clear ma? Next, third example see here, three alkyl groups are completely different. This is methyl group, this is ethyl group, this is propyl group, completely differ. So in this case same category, so it's considered as a simple amines, but this two one is a mixed combination, that's why it's a mixed amines. Okay ma? See my dear students, most important key point, simple amines examples and mixed amines example you observed in the 2 degree amines and 3 degree amines. It's nothing but secondary amines and tertiary amines. It's not present in the 1 degree amines. Clear ma? Now, whenever you will see organic compound containing nitrogen like amines category, this is the simple representation. If 1 degree amines means NH2 group is present, very very important nana NH2 group is present. 2 degree means only NH groups are present in the given organic compound. If any one of the organic compound contains NH group, that's considered as a 2 degree. It means here two alkyl groups are there, same alkyl group or same aryl group or different alkyl group and different aryl groups are there. But a 3 degree means only N is there. That is the most important. If only N is present in the given organic compound, that is a 3 degree. For example, see here, this three examples are belongings to the category of the tertiary amines. It is nothing but 3 degree amine. Why? Because only nitrogen atom is there. But above example, NH groups are there. NH groups is nothing but 2 degree amines. Now here, NH2 groups means it's a 1 degree amines. It's a clear nana? 1 degree amines and 2 degree amines and 3 degree amines. Once again I repeated, finally, amines are nothing but ammonia derivatives compound. Ammonia derivatives compound. These are formed by the replacement of one or more hydrogen atom by the corresponding number of alkyl group or aryl group. These are the primary amines and secondary amines or tertiary amines. Okay, nana? This is the introduction part, my dear students. Now, the second concept is classification of amines. Classification of amines. My dear students, generally amines basically two categories based on the R group, based on R group. Now, two different type of category, aliphatic amines, second one aromatic amines. If aromatic amine means probably benzene rings are directly attached to either NH2 group or NH group or N group. This is the category of aromatic amine. But aliphatic amine means R group is nothing but open chain compounds or alkyl group directly attaches to the nitrogen, either NH2 or NH or N, that is called aliphatic. Now listen, my dear students, aliphatic amines. Amines are further classified into two category. Number one, aliphatic. Number two, the aromatic. In case of aliphatic, listen very carefully. In this type of amines, the nitrogen atoms is directly attaches to the nitrogen atom directly attaches to one or two or three same or different alkyl groups and aryl group, alkyl groups only, not aryl groups. Because of alkyl groups, it's called aliphatic amines. Aliphatic amine. Once again repeated, my dear students, what is the aliphatic amine, ma? In this type of the amines, the nitrogen atoms is directly attaches to nitrogen atom directly attaches to one or two or three same or different alkyl groups are called aliphatic amines. Now see, this compound name is a ethyl amine. Why it's called ethyl amine? Ethyl is the aliphatic group. This directly attaches to the amine NH2. Already clearly explained, if NH2 is present in any given organic compound from the nitrogen compound, that is a 1 degree amines. That is the most important, my dear students, 1 degree amine. If NH group is present in any given organic compound, that is a 2 degree amines. If N only present, that is a 3 degree amines. This is ethyl amine, but aliphatic category of ethyl amine. Why call aliphatic? This R group. R group is a open chain compound. Open chain compound R group. That's why it is a ethyl amine or 3 degree amine. And see one more example. Here, two different type of alkyl groups are there, but same groups. It means simple amines. It is a simple amine. Dimethyl amine is nothing but 2 degree amines. Why it's called 2 degree amines? This nitrogen group directly attaches to the two alkyl group. This nitrogen atom directly attaches to the two alkyl group. So that's called 2 degree. In this case, nitrogen atom directly attaches to one alkyl group. That's why it is a 1 degree amines. Now here, this is a dimethyl amine. Dimethyl means two methyl groups are there. So amine group. The dimethyl amine is a secondary amines or 2 degree amines. Now in the third example, see, three alkyl groups are there. Same three alkyl group. That's why this compound name is, my dear students, trimethyl amine or 3 degree amines. These are the aliphatic category of the amines. Aliphatic category of the amines. Now, the second one is the aromatic amines. My dear student, this can further be classified into two types. Number one is aryl amines. See here, number one, aryl amines, and number two, alkyl amines. Alkyl amines is not there here. In my next class, I will explain that alkyl amines or side chain substituent amines. Now, aryl amines. It is a first category from the aromatic amine. Very, very important point in a neat level. Aryl amines are another name is a nucleus substitutional amines or nuclear substitutional amines. The aryl amines is nothing but here alkyl group, here R group is a aryl group. The R group is a aryl group. So that is a actually aryl amines, another name is a nucleus substitutional amines also. Now in this type of amines, the nitrogen atom is directly attaches to one or two or three aromatic rings. These are called aryl amines or generally nucleus substituted amines. So my dear students, this aryl amines and one more example, Aryl alkyl amines are aryl amines. Both of them is the category of the aromatic. Here aromatic amines means R group is the act as a aryl group. So in this type of amines, nitrogen atom is directly attaches to one or two or three aromatic rings. Aryl amines directly attaches to, here nitrogen atom is directly attaches to either one aromatic ring or two aromatic ring or three aromatic ring. That is called aryl amines. My dear students, one more important point, from the aryl amines again classified into three category: primary aryl amines, secondary aryl amines, and tertiary aryl amines. Primary aryl amines and secondary aryl amines or tertiary aryl amines. So now in this primary aryl amines, when one or more amino groups, important na, primary means already I said very clearly NH2 group is there. From the aryl amines category, primary amines, when one or more amino groups or attaches to the nucleus, here nucleus is nothing but it's a aromatic ring. The nucleus is nothing but aromatic ring. Here in this category, primary amines category, either one amino group or more than one amino group directly attaches to aromatic ring or nucleus, that is called primary amines, my dear students. Now here some examples are there, just to see carefully. NH2 already I said very clearly, if any one of the organic compound contains NH2, the basically that is a 1 degree amine. Now this is 1 degree amine, but the aromatic ring is there, that's why it is a aryl amine. So this compound name is common benzene amine, but common name is aniline. This is the most important, na C6H5NH2. Actually the entire ring name, ring formula C6H5NH2, this is aniline or benzene amine. Now in this nucleus is nothing but aromatic ring or aryl ring. Here two amino groups are present here. So this compound name is, my dear students, metaposition. See, this is ortho, is a meta and a para. Now here one amine group is located in the metaposition, that's why this compound name is meta diaminobenzene. Why it's called meta diaminobenzene? Two amino groups are there directly attaches to the benzene ring, that's why this compound name is a meta diaminobenzene. Or another name is also, my dear student, metaphenylene diamine, or common name is a meta diaminobenzene. Now here one methyl group, one amino group is directly attaches to the aromatic ring, that's why this compound name is a para position, ortho meta para position, no amino groups are there, that's why this compound name is a para amino toluene. Actually, CH3 directly attaches to the benzene ring, that is called toluene. But additionally, NH2 group also present here. Additionally, NH2 group also present here. That's why the NH2 groups where is located? In the para position. That's why this compound name is, my dear students, para amino toluene, or another name is a para toluodine. Para toluodine. Now, third example, two amino groups are there and continuously attaches to the neighboring carbon. That's why this compound name is 1,2-diaminobenzene. 1,2-diaminobenzene. See carefully, my dear students, amino group directly attaches to the aromatic ring. That's why it is a category of aryl amines of primary amines. Okay, now? Now, second one, secondary amines. Secondary amines means when NH group is attached, already clearly explained, na 2 degree means NH groups is present. If any one of the organic compound contains only NH group, that is considered as a 2 degree amines. Now, when NH group is attached to either 2 aryl groups or 1 aryl group, 1 alkyl group. Here, my dear student, NH group contains same category of the aryl groups or same aryl group or alkyl group, that is a 2 degree amines. Now see here, NH group, right side 1 R, left side 1 R. This is one benzene ring, this is also one benzene ring, same category of group. Same category means same aryl groups. That's why, my dear students, this compound name is diphenyl amine. Why it's called diphenyl amine? This is amine group, but actually C6H5. From the benzene ring, one hydrogen is replaced. This is a C6H5, this is a C6H5. In chemistry point of view, C6H5 is commonly known as phenyl group. How many phenyl groups are there here? 2 phenyl group. This 2 phenyl group directly attaches to the amine group. That's why this compound name is a diphenyl amine. Diphenyl amine. And one more name is also there, ma. Captelian phenyl aniline. Actually, this is a aniline. In this aniline, one more N group is there. That's why here N phenyl aniline or N phenyl amine also. Now here in this example, two R groups are same category, aryl group. But now here, this is the amine group, NH2 group is amine group. This is aliphatic category, alkyl group. This is a aromatic category, aryl group. So, one alkyl group, one aryl groups are there. This compound name is methyl phenyl amine. Methyl phenyl. According to alphabetical order, methyl phenyl amine, or another name is N-methyl aniline. N-methyl aniline. This is the secondary amines of aryl amines. And last and final category, my dear students, tertiary amines from the category of aryl amines. It's nothing but aromatic category amines. When here N, already clearly explained, N is present in any given organic compound, that is considered as a 3 degree or tertiary. So when 3 alkyl group or 3 aryl group, and 3 aryl group directly attaches to the nitrogen atom, that is called tertiary amine. Now see here in this example, this is N, this is one alkyl group, this is one alkyl group, this is one alkyl group. This is a simple amines. Why it's called simple amines? Same category of the aryl groups are there here. So this compound name is very simple, triphenyl. One phenyl, two phenyl, three phenyl. Triphenyl amine. This is the triphenyl amine. It's a simple amine because of the same alkyl groups, same aryl groups are there. Now one more example, see right now here. This is alkyl, this is aryl group. So this compound name is, my dear student, N, dimethyl aniline. N, N is represented. So this N is connected with here, here, and phenyl. So this N connected with one methyl group, one more methyl group. That's why it's represented NN. NNN means nitro group. N, dimethyl aniline. This is completely aniline. Okay, ma? From aromatic amines category, one part is completed. That is called aryl amines. In my next class, I will be continue another part of aromatic amines. That is aryl amines. After nomenclature, we'll start. Okay, Nana, this is the introduction part of amines and the classification of the amines. Clear?